Hello, and welcome to your last videotaping for a viola lesson. We've done a lot this semester. We've looked at posture, holding the bow, drawing out on open strings, and we even worked with the twinkle team. Today, we're going to be working with two scales. Scale is a series from one point to another. Two things we need to identify first is two things called major and minor. Major sounds happy. Minor sounds sad. So I'm going to go to the piano quick, and I'm going to play two little tunes for you. And I'm going to ask you which one sounds happy and which one sounds sad, okay? So this is going to be the first one, and then I'll play the second one. So here's the first one. So that would be, right, so that would be major. Awesome. So here's the second one. Right, because it sounds sad. Cool. So those are examples in songs, right? You can hear it all the time when you listen to music. It could be like in a happy song, in a sad song, and you can hear. When it's happy, it's major. When it's sad, it's minor. That's the way I like to think of it. So here, I'm just going to play just one group of notes, and I want you to see if it's happy, major, or minor. So here's the first one.
Major.
Nice. And the second one. So you hear that there is a difference,
yeah.
Right?
I hear it.
Cool. Very nice. Okay, so let's go over to the instrument. I'm sorry, before we do, since we're learning it with a scale today, I'm going to play a scale on the piano first. I want you to identify which one is which. Right, sounds happy. And the second one. Very nice. Okay, so if you can hear those distinct differences. Okay, so the major scale is going to be pretty much a review, right? So if we're going to start on the G string and we're going to play the G scale, what two open strings are we going to use?
G and D.
Right, great. And if let's see if you remember what the finger pattern might be. If you were to start on the open G string, we're not going to play it yet, but I just want you to tell me what the fingers might be, what the pattern is.
Open, close, one, two, three.
Mm-hmm, great. And then what's after that?
Open D.
Yes. And then keeps going, right?
Close, one, two, three.
Three, right. So we have that pattern of open, one, two, three. And then the open string, the next one over, open, one, two, three, right? So the pattern repeats. Now, remember, we have to go up and go back down. When we go back down on a scale, do we put our fingers down or lift them off?
Put them down and lift them off.
Right, so they're down and then you lift them off. Very good. So I'm going to do the first three notes in the major scale, okay? And I want you to repeat. We're going to do kind of a call and response. So let's get into playing position. Great. Let's make sure everything's proper. Good. Heads up, instruments out. Hand frame looks great. The wrist is straight. Good. Make sure the fingers are over. Okay. And the bow looks pretty good. Perpendicular to the string, you have a nice 90 degree angle. Great. So let's first try with just the open G string. I want you to try open G and then putting down your first finger on the G string. So I'll go first, and I just want you to do open and first finger after me. So I'll go first. Okay.
Is it close?
Right, so the first note will be open. I'm sorry, I didn't explain enough. First note will be open G. And then the second note will be first finger down on the G string. Well, let's give that a try. Okay, So how does that sound to you? I'm going to play mine again, and I want you to listen and try it again.
So should I go lower on the one?
That's it. Very nice. So you adjusted your finger, right, to make it sound correct.
Mm-hmm.
The confusing part, I've explained this before, I might have forgotten. This is going up the fingerboard, okay? It's a little backwards. Mm-hmm. This is going down. So you moved your finger
down.
Up, right, because this is upward, right? Yeah, because you're going down the... Right, I would. It makes sense why you think that you're going down the instrument, but you're going up in pitch, right? You're mm-hmm. going up the fingerboard. Okay. Cool. Mm-hmm. All right, so let's try. So the first... okay, so let's try, if we remember the pattern, it's open, first finger, and then where is 2 and 3?
Slightly below.
And then above. Three. Yeah, above. Above. Yeah, right. And then what's special about 2 and 3?
They're close together.
Great. So let's try the first few notes, open, 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to go first, and then you are, okay? So watch me first. Let's try that one more time, a smidge lower, meaning this way, smidge. It was a little too high. Let's try it one more time. Excellent, very cool. All right, so now that we've done that half in the major scale, we're gonna go to the open. Great. So let's try that again, and so I'll go first, and then you will go. So I'll do the open 1, 2, 3. Sounds awesome. Okay, just something to point out. This was my mistake before, not noticing. Your bow, I want you to look, I know it's kind of weird. Look at the camera if you want to face this way, and tell me, is your bow crooked or straight?
Crooked.
Right, so how can we fix that?
Is it straight now?
There you go, right? So you want to move your elbow and your arm, that's it. You had it right before, this way. You want to go outward. There you go, right, that is outward, right? You want to move your arm and elbow back. Good, so that looks... more. So I'm just going to move it for you. There you go. See how that's straight? Okay. So it's a little odd looking at from that perspective. Okay, cool. So just something to be aware of. Everything else looks pretty good. Try to remember to hold your instrument up a little bit more. Great. So now let's try going up the scale all the way, right? So we did the first two parts. So I'm going to play the scale first, and then you are, okay? So I'll go first. So does that sound right or needs to be adjusted?
I think it needs to be adjusted.
Okay, so let's try that again. The first half was really good. So let's try from the beginning, and when you get to the D string, just think a little bit higher, okay? Oh, so let me just help you out here. That's where you want to start. Thank you. Okay, not bad. Pretty good. So let's take it from, let's go back down the scale now. So now we're at the top. Let's match that pitch. We had the third finger on the D string, right? Cool. Just watch a little crooked. There you go. Good. Okay, so as we go back down, we're going to remove the fingers, right? So I'll go first with the first half. Good. Now, what's going to happen next?
Fingers on the D string.
G string. Because we went from the D string to the G. Right. Okay, so let's, I'm not even going to do it this time. Let's hear you do the rest. Almost. Can we try that half one more time? What finger do you need to fix? First finger, right? Good. One thing I would suggest about your tone production, like with the bow, do you notice that your bow is close to the bridge, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try to move it a little bit closer to the fingerboard, so about there. You get a better sound. Good. So let's do it. Now we're going to play it together. We're going to go up the major scale and back down, okay? Ready? Here we go. So let's keep those things in mind. Ready? Go. Open D first, right? Good. Now we're going to go to the G string, third finger. Up. So let's bring that up a little more. Nice. Very good. Okay. So now we're going to move on to the minor scale. The minor scale, this. So the major scale sounded happy, right? The minor scale, there's going to be a difference. Before we had second and finger close to each other, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The second finger now is going to move. It's going to go down to the first finger. So now what two fingers are touching?
The first and second.
Right. So one and two are touching, right? So before, it was there was the space between one and two and three were touching. Now there's going to be one and two touching. So let's try the first half of the minor scale. So I'm going to go first, and then you. Let's try that again. Instrument up a little bit more. Posture is really going to help here. Let's bring the first finger up a little bit to make it better in tune. Good. Let's try it from there. Try it again. I'm going to move this right here. I know, it's kind of difficult to think about all at the same time. Nice. So make sure the one and two are very close and the three is far away. Good. Now, the D string, it gets a little different. We have the open D as usual, right? So do you remember that? What position is this called? The one we're normally in. Right. So for here, we're going to go. Remember how I was mentioning there's that little space behind here, the first position.
Mm-hmm.
This, if you remember, is called half position. So we're going to go into half position. So now it's going to be right at the top of the fingerboard, right? So we're going to do an open D string and then first finger all the way as close as you can on the D string, you know, as low as possible. So watch me first. See if you could try that.